Hello, Gundam fans. This is Prime92, and today I'll be looking at the Moment 44 High Grade P-Bandai, Vayeate, and Mercurius. And I got the model kits from Canadian Gundam. Link is in the description below. So, these are essentially the same mobile suits, with different colors, different heads, and accessories. But they look great. The only stickers on the bodies are the cameras. That's it. Everything else is plastic, but the accessories do have some stickers on them. But they're really done well. Articulation will be the same for all of them, like for both of them. Got pretty good articulation. I was kind of worried. And nothing, as far as I can tell, is carried over from the Leo High Grade. This is all new sculpt. I was actually really surprised. Even trying to get this front piece to move. And I think the best part of articulation is this extra hinge in the crotch. To allow the leg to go farther than it probably should, considering how bulky it is. You've actually got some pretty good articulation for these guys, considering the overall design of these things. I'm very impressed, at how articulate these two guys are, and how unique they are compared to the other, like the Leo that we already have. So first off, I want to mention that both mobile suits have optional visor pieces, so it looks like the visor is actually flipped up, and you can see the Leo-esque camera. Each one has a sticker. And also, where the normal helmets, the color ring here is plastic, here they're just stickers, which I guess kind of makes sense. It's an optional thing, so they don't want to give too much parts count. Now, with the Mercurius, of course, you have the shield, which is also a beam saber. It comes with two yellow beams. And the beam gun, which has a sticker here. Kind of ugly, I think, but I guess it's the way it's supposed to be. Holds them very well. And of course you have the planet defensors, which can all separate and be used on these two stands. You have them up or forward, depending on how you want to have them displayed. So I think that's kind of cool, that we can actually display them off the Mercurius. And then of course the Vayeate's beam cannon, which you just have to connect the back piece here, which has the wire, onto the actual cannon itself. And the best way I find to do it is untab this part, this arm from the cannon, bring this all the way around, and then tab it back in once you have it in the position you want. It just makes it a lot easier because you got a hinge here, and the actual energy, the energy container can move as well. And also open up to reveal more stickers. So, it also has the sticker here and more on the barrel. So yeah, it works really well. You get a good position with that cannon. So the accessories are nice and you can display them nicely too. Well, since I was talking about the Leo before, let's compare the Mercurius and Vayeate to the Leo High Grade. And also, we don't have a Tall Geese High Grade yet, but we do have the real grade. And these look great together because I think the Tall Geese is taller than all three of these. So it does make sense. He's a little taller, not by much compared to these guys, but they are definitely supposed to be taller than the Leo. This is a great display on a shelf. So I love these two kits. They are more expensive because they are P-Bandai. They come in a two-pack, which is a way it actually makes sense, I think. So I'm very happy with these. They're very good. So if you want to pick them up, click the link below to go to Canadian Gundam, and I'll see you in the next review.